As you wish. That didn't happen. Okay.
Farah, no!
That's not how it happened.
Thank you.
Done. I'll start the story from here next time.
Bravely I have fought and slain my enemies. Honor and glory are mine. But though I fight until the desert sands themselves were red with blood, I could not bring back the dead. No. No.
I will give you power. Eternal life will be yours.
Live forever, and those I loved dead and I to blame. I choose death. Do not be afraid. This belongs to you.
The dagger of time. But it is locked away within my father's treasure vault. How?
Most people think time is like a river that flows swift and sure in one direction. But I have seen the face of time, and I can tell you, they are wrong. Time is an ocean in a storm. You may wonder who I am and why I say this. Sit down. And I will tell you the tale like none that you have ever heard. No further. I am the son. And that is why I have come. To warn you and your father to arrest this treacherous vizier before he betrays you and brings ruin on us all. His signal is a flaming arrow shot into the air. Prevent him, and my father's army will know the traitor has been unmasked. They will turn back.
A wild tale indeed. I have a simpler version. A Persian soldier, lusting for glory, entered the chambers of the Maharaja's daughter and was slain by me. Your Highness, for your own safety, I suggest you flee. I'll handle this intruder. Makudima Kepa. Hear that both showed a taste for ease and plunder.
You waste your breath. What will you say?
Did you really think you could defeat me?
Careful! Don't tire yourself.
You might be a party.
Was a traitor.
Take this. Return it to your father's treasure vault.
Guard it well.
I owe you thanks. But why did you invent such a fantastic story? Do you think me a child that I would believe such nonsense? I said I owe you thanks. You presume too much. Story. Do you think me a child that I would believe such nonsense?
You're right. It was just a story.
Wait. I don't even know your name.
Just call me Kakulukiya.